we have a really cool rifle, the Henry Repeating Arms U.S. Survival Rifle, the AR-7, and 22 Long Rifle. We're going to try to be pretty quick today. You'll notice the weather looks pretty rough around here. We have a storm that's almost here. We're supposed to get several inches of rain, and I just got lucky. It's dry right now. The storm hasn't gotten here yet, so we are going to experience a lot of wind noise on camera, so I do apologize for that. I'm going to try to do most of my voiceover in the studio, but I do want to show you guys this rifle. What a sweet little rifle this AR-7 is. Let's get rolling. The Armalite that we are all familiar with was owned by Fairchild Engine and Airplane Corporation. Fairchild already had an established relationship with the Air Force. When Fairchild created Armalite, they developed the 22 Hornet caliber MA-1 or the AR-5. The Air Force quickly adopted it as their survival rifle. This was a rifle that they could pack in a very tight package and carry on board with them in the hull of the airplane or wherever they needed to go in the event there was a downed aircraft or something where the pilot would need some kind of a survival type rifle. The old AR-5 was a bolt action rifle. A few years later, 1959, the 22 long rifle was implemented as the caliber of choice for the survival rifle, which in turn became the AR-7. This rifle was only 16.5 inches long, and it was made of, just like Armalite was known for, the composite materials, aluminum, plastic, and things of that nature. Once everything was inside the actual stock and closed up, this entire unit would float in the event it was submerged or dropped into water. The unit is extremely easy to assemble. You'll notice the stock cover has these little ridges on it. That pretty much tells you where you need to pry. This is the easiest point to get the lid off. Once you remove the lid, you simply take the various components, like the receiver, put it in place. You'll notice that there's a bolt that runs through the grip up into where it's going to assemble into the receiver. It takes several turns, about 15 or 20 turns, and then you'll have your receiver connected to your buttstock. Then you take your barrel, and you notice you have this chamber pin and this chamber notch. They go into one another. They fit perfectly into one another. If you want to make this thing a little bit easier to seat, you can pull the bolt back a little bit to relieve some of the pressure, and that's going to make the barrel seat a little bit easier into the receiver. But either way, it will affix easily, and then this one's kind of long-winded also with the threading. The unit ships with two magazines, very, very easy to use. Easy to insert, easy to remove. There's two ways that you can remove them. One would be with the trigger finger, but that also requires a trigger finger in the trigger guard. And you know, most of us aren't comfortable, if we're not shooting, of having that finger in the trigger guard, but it would make for a quick disconnect if you needed to get that thing out of there. The other way is simply to use the thumb of your support hand to push the lever while you're kind of pulling the magazine out. Either way is just as easy as the other. I was able to shoot this thing out to almost 60 yards with no problem. The sights out of the box came very easy to use. They are adjustable. However, I did not have to adjust them at all. Again, out to 60, right at 60 yards. When you're done shooting, it's just as easy to disassemble the rifle, and you simply put it all back into the stock. Very little wiggle and rattle in this thing because the inside components fit perfectly inside here. It's molded to fit around all of your components, so there's not a ton of rattle. This is a perfect gun to have on a camping outing, if you're going four-wheeling, motorcycle riding, anything like that, or if you're flying and you need to just have some kind of firepower with you, as the Air Force obviously did. Guys, what a fun little gun this AR-7 is. It's a ton of fun to shoot. I see this as not only a great survival type gun, but if you're wanting to introduce a youngster to the shooting sports and shooting safety of any kind, I would highly recommend the AR-7. Comes in at a very affordable price, $250. You're gonna find these things for most of the time. Very manageable, as you can see. It's not intimidating looking. Obviously, you have the report that's very low because it's a 22 long rifle, but it's a small, manageable gun. So it's gonna take that intimidation factor away from any youth that you might be teaching and introducing to firearms. I really like this thing. I definitely see this thing as a cool backpack gun. Throw in your backpack with a safety kit, water, things like that. And you know, just take it wherever you're going, maybe camping. Perfect rifle. Again, I love the portability of it. As you see, the accuracy is pretty awesome, even shooting at some of these crazy would-bes out here. I did seem to wing one at least. Shout out to my homie right there in case he didn't make it. But this thing is really cool. Very, very accurate, very portable, as I said, and a lot of fun to shoot.